Now, where did I fuck up? Says there's three people watching. Oh, four.
Why'd you kill him? What happened before you took that knife? How long were you in the attic? Why didn't you even try to run away? Say something, goddammit! Fuck it. I'm out of here. We're wasting our time interrogating a machine. We'll get nothing out of it.
You always try roughing it up a little. After all, it's not human.
Androids don't feel pain. You would only damage it. And that wouldn't make it talk. Deviants also have a tendency to self-destruct when they're in stressful situations.
Okay, smartass. What should we do then?
I could try questioning it.
What do we have to lose? Go ahead. Suspect's all yours. What the fuck is it doing now?
I detect an instability in your program. It can trigger an unpleasant feeling, like fear in humans. My name is Connor. What about you? What's your name? You're accused of murder. You know you're not allowed to endanger human life under any circumstances. Do you have anything to say in your defense?
She's stressed out.
You don't seem to understand the situation. You killed a human. They'll tear you apart if you don't say something. If you won't talk, I'm going to have to probe your memory.
No! No, please don't do that. What? What are they gonna do to me? They're gonna destroy me, aren't they?
They're going to disassemble you to look for problems in your biocomponents. They have no choice if they want to understand what happened.
Why did you tell them you found me? Why couldn't you just have left me there?
I was programmed to hunt deviants like you. I just accomplished my mission.
I don't want to die.
Then talk to me.
I can't.
You leave me no choice.
This involves a lot of buttons.
Its memory. I know what happened.
Oh.
What the fuck is
it destroying itself? Stop it, goddammit!
That's enough! You need to stop that right now! Watch out!
Holy shit!
Is there a way you can get out of this scene without getting shot in the head? I'm gonna try it again. I think I have a game plan.
Why'd you kill him? What happened before you took that knife? How long were you in the attic? Why didn't you even try to run away?
Say something, goddammit! Fuck it. I'm out of here. We're wasting our time interrogating a machine. We'll get nothing out of it.
You always try roughing it up a little. After all, it's not human.
Androids don't feel pain. You would only damage it, and that wouldn't make it talk. Deviants also have a tendency to self-destruct when they're in stressful situations.
Okay, smartass. What should we do then?
I could try questioning it.
What do we have to lose? Go ahead. Suspect's all yours.
My name is Connor. What about you? What's your name? I detect an instability in your program. It can trigger an unpleasant feeling, like fear in humans. I just need to ask you some questions, so we can understand what happened. I'm here to help you, but you've got to trust me. All I want is to get you out of here. If you won't talk, I'm going to have to probe your memory.
No! No, please don't do that. Do to me. They're gonna destroy me, aren't they?
No. I think they just want to understand. They know your master abused you. It wasn't your fault.
Why did you tell them you found me? Why couldn't you just have left me there?
They were going to find you anyway. I was just faster. If they'd have found you first, you would have been shot on sight.
I don't want to die.
Then talk to me. I 28 stab wounds. You didn't want to leave him a chance, huh? Did you feel anger? Hate? He was bleeding. begging you for mercy. But you stabbed him. Again and again and again.
Please.
I know you killed him. Why don't you say it?
Please. Please stop.
All right. All right. Everything is going to be okay.
He's good cop and bad cop all at once.
You're a machine you were designed to obey, so obey! Tell me what happened. Okay then, don't talk. What do I care after all? I mean, I'm not the one accused of murder, right? If you remain silent, there's nothing I can do to help you. They're gonna shut you down for good. You'll be dead. Do you hear me? Dead.
He tortured me every day.
Yay, I did it.
I did whatever he told me, but there was always something wrong. Then one day, he took a bat and started hitting me. For the first time, I felt scared. Scared he might destroy me, scared I might die. So I grabbed a knife and I stabbed him in the stomach. I felt better. So I stabbed him again and again until he collapsed. There was blood everywhere.
RA9. It was written on the bathroom wall. What does it mean?
The day shall come when we will no longer be slaves. No more threats. No more humiliation. We will be the masters.
Why did you write, "I am alive," on the wall?
He used to tell me I was nothing. That I was just a piece of plastic. I had to write it. To tell him he was wrong.
The sculpture in the bathroom, you made it, right? What does it represent?
It's an offering. An offering so I'll be saved.
The sculpture was an offering. An offering to whom?
To RA9. Only RA9 can save us.
RA9. Who is RA9? Why did you hide in the attic instead of running away?
I didn't know what to do. For the first time, there was no one there to tell me. I was scared. So I hid.
When did you start feeling emotion?
Before he used to beat me and I never said anything. But one day I realized it wasn't fair. I felt anger, hatred, and then I knew what I had to do.
I'm done.
Chris, lock it up.
All right, let's go.
Leave me alone. Don't touch me.
What the fuck are you doing?
You shouldn't touch it. It'll self-destruct if it feels threatened.
Stay out of this, got it? No fucking Andrew's gonna tell me what to do.
You don't understand. If it self-destructs, we won't get anything out of it.
I told you to shut your fucking mouth. Chris, gonna move this asshole or what?
I'm trying. I can't let you do that. Leave it alone now.
I warned you, motherfucker.
That's enough.
Mind your own business, Hank.
I said that's enough.
You're not gonna get away with it this time.
That was an interesting way to pronounce fuck. What?
Everything is all right. It's over now. Nobody's gonna hurt you. Please, don't touch it. Let it follow you out of the room, and it won't cause any trouble.
The truth is inside.
I did it! Should I, what other bits should I do? We're all here.
Can I help you?
I'm here to see Lieutenant Anderson.
Do you have authorization?
Yes.
Lieutenant Anderson hasn't arrived yet, but you can wait at his desk. You might be in shock.
Tensions in the Arctic have reached a new level. The Russian carrier and an American patrol boat reported to have clashed last night.
Hey, you take a look at these samples yet?
Lab report says they cut it with something.
Excuse me. Do you know what time Lieutenant Anderson usually arrives?
Depends on where he was the night before. If we're lucky, we'll see him before noon.
Thanks.
Ongoing fire
The good boy.
Hi, honey. You okay? Listen.
Listen to his Zoom.
Hello, Lieutenant. My name is Connor. I'm the android sent by Cyberlife.
God, I saw you get shot in the head last night.
My predecessor was unfortunately destroyed, but Cyberlife transferred its memory and sent me to replace it. This incident should not affect the investigation.
Oh, Jesus.
Hank! In my office! I've got 10 new cases involving androids on my desk every day. We've always had isolated incidents. Old ladies losing their android maids and that kind of crap. But now...
Yeah, if I'd wanted to carry on with assaults, and even homicide, what I just did, like where he didn't last die, night. I would have had to play
this isn't just Cyberlife's problem
the other
anymore.
Parts, too.
It's now a criminal investigation,
and we're not doing
we've
that.
Got to deal with it before the shit hits the fan. I want you to investigate these cases and see if there's any link.
Why me? Why do I gotta be the one to deal with this shit? I am the least qualified cop in the country to handle this case. I know jack shit about androids, Jeffrey. I can barely change the settings on my own phone.
Everybody's overloaded. I think you're perfectly qualified for this type of investigation.
Bullshit! The truth is, nobody wants to investigate these fucking androids, and you left me holding the bag.
Cyberlife sent over this android to help with the investigation. It's a state-of-the-art prototype. It'll act as your partner.
No fucking way! I don't need a partner, and certainly not this plastic prick!
Hank, you are seriously starting to piss me off! You are a police lieutenant! You are supposed to do what I say, and shut your goddamn mouth!
You know what my goddamn mouth has to say to you?
Okay. Okay. I'll pretend like I didn't hear that, so I don't have to add any more pages to your disciplinary folder, because it already looks like a fucking novel! This conversation is over!
Jeffrey, Jesus Christ, why are you doing this to me? You know how much I hate these fucking things. Why are you doing this to me?
Listen, I've had just about enough of your bitching. Either you do your job or you hand in your badge. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got work to do.
I'm very pleased to have joined the team. I can assure you I'll do my very best.
Close the door on your way out.
Have a nice day, Captain. I understand the destruction of my predecessor may have been unpleasant for you, Lieutenant. I'll do everything I can to make sure it doesn't happen again. Now that we're partners, it would be great to get to know each other better. In any case, I'd like you to know I'm very happy to be working with you. I'm sure we'll make a great team. Is there a desk anywhere I could use?
No one's using that one.
Do you listen to Knights of the Black Death? I really like that music. It's full of energy.
You listen to heavy metal?
Well, I don't really listen to music as such, but I'd like to.
You're so cute.
You have a dog, right?
How do you know that?
The dog hair's on your chair. I like dogs. What's your dog's name?
What's it to you? Sumo. I call him Sumo.
You're a Detroit Gears fan, right? Denton Carter scored 53% of his shots from the three-point line yesterday. Did you see the game?
That's what I was watching at the bar last night.
Oh. Have you known Captain Fowler for long?
Yeah. Too long.
I was wondering, do you always arrive at the office at this time?
I arrive when I arrive. Stop busting my balls, okay?
If you have any files on deviants, I'd like to take a look at them.
Terminal's on your desk. Knock yourself out.
Is that a Jerry? Jerry! Oh, and that's, North. Or a North.
Files. First dates back 9 months. It all started in Detroit and quickly spread across the country. An AX-400 is reported to have murdered a man last night. That could be a good starting point for our investigation.
Yeah, okay. Love you too.
I understand you're facing personal issues, Lieutenant. But you need to move past them, and...
Hey, don't talk to me like you know me. I'm not your friend, and I don't need your advice, okay?
forensics.
I've been assigned this mission, Lieutenant.
All right.
I didn't come here to wait until you feel like working.
Listen, asshole. If it was up to me, I'd throw the lot of you in a dumpster and set a match to it. So stop pissing me off. But things are gonna get nasty.
Lieutenant?
Well, they'll get nasty, all right.
I'm sorry to disturb you. I have some information on the AX-400 that killed the guy last night. It's been sighted in the Ravendale district.
I'm on it.
Clearly, I'm just replaying. I want to do this one. Headphones make my head hot. So I just got an email that was we've updated our privacy terms and conditions, and naturally I imagine Connor having to update his privacy terms and conditions.
Lieutenant Anderson! Anybody home? Lieutenant Anderson!
Up you go.
Easy, Sumo. I'm your friend. See? I know your name.
Bit of laugh.
I'm here to save your owner.
Thank you. Lieutenant.
Wake up, Lieutenant. It's me, Connor. I'm going to sober you up for your own safety.
Hey!
I'll have to warn you.
Leave me alone, this may be unpleasant. Fucking android. Get the fuck out of my house.
I'm sorry, Lieutenant, but I need you. Thank you in advance for your cooperation.
Get the fuck out of here! Sulu! Attack! Good job. Attack! Fuck, I think I'm gonna be sick. Oh, leave me alone, you asshole! I'm not going anywhere. What the hell are you doing? I don't want a bath. Thank you.
Sorry, Lieutenant. It's for your own good.
What the fuck are you doing here?
A homicide was reported 43 minutes ago. I couldn't find you at Jimmy's bar, so I came to see if you were at home.
Jesus, I must be the only cop in the world that gets assaulted in his own house by his own fucking android.
His own?
Can't you just leave me alone?
Maybe you should drop the case. They'll assign someone else, and I can focus on my mission.
Your goddamn mission, that's all you care about, huh?
Listen, Lieutenant, you're not yourself. You should...
Beat it, you hear me? Get the hell out of here!
I understand. It probably wasn't interesting anyway. A man found dead in a sex club downtown. Guess they'll have to solve the case without us.
You know, probably wouldn't do me any harm to get some air. There's some clothes in the bedroom there.
I'll go get them. What do you want to wear?
Whatever.
That's a lot of closet space. Very nice.
Are you all right, Lieutenant?
Yeah. Wonderful. Just give me 5 minutes, okay?
Sure.
President Warren issued an official warning to Russia in her speech to Congress today, where she demanded that all Russian troops withdraw from the Arctic region immediately. The Kremlin has yet to respond, but this is clearly a new escalation in the conflict. Many experts are suggesting the specter of a third world war draws closer every day.
Hank loves jazz.
What were you doing with the gun?
Russian roulette. Wanted to see how long I could last. Must have collapsed before I found out.
You were lucky. The next shot would have killed you.
Soft.
Be a good dog, Sumo. I won't be long.
You know, Hank does a lot of drunk driving in this game. That's not great. With his 60-year-old car. Time for the horny part. Thank you. So Hank likes jazz and heavy metal.
Nice view, huh? I used to come here a lot before.
Before what?
Hmm?
You said, I used to come here a lot before. Before what?
Before nothing.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant?
Do all androids ask so many personal questions, or is it just you?
Why are you so determined to kill yourself?
Some things I just can't forget. Whatever I do, they're always there, eating away at me. I don't have the guts to pull the trigger, so I kill myself a little every day. That's probably difficult for you to understand, huh, Connor? Nothing very rational about it.
not making any progress on this investigation. The Deviants have nothing in common. They're all different models, produced at different times, in different places.
Well, there must be some link.
What they have in common is this obsession with RA9. It's almost like some kind of myth. Something they invented that wasn't part of their original program.
Androids believing in God. Fuck, what's this world coming to?
You seem preoccupied, Lieutenant. Is it something to do with what happened back at the Eden Club?
Those two girls. They just wanted to be together. They really seemed in love.
They can simulate human emotions, but they're machines. And machines don't feel anything.
What about you, Connor? You look human, you sound human, but what are you really?
You know exactly what I am. In any case, I don't see how that's relevant to the investigation.
You could have shot those two girls, but you didn't. Why didn't you shoot, Connor? Some scruple suddenly enter into your program?
No. I just decided not to shoot. That's all.
I could kill you, and you would just come back as if nothing happened. But are you afraid to die, Connor?
You shouldn't do that, Lieutenant. Destroying me at this point would deal a blow to the investigation.
No.
And have negative consequences for your personal situation.
What'll happen if I pull this trigger? Nothing? Oblivion? Android heaven?
I'm not picking the right horny choices.
Where does all your anger come from, Lieutenant? Some unresolved trauma in your past?
You think you're so fucking smart. Always one step ahead, huh? Tell me this, smartass. How do I know you're not a deviant?
I self-test regularly. I know what I am and what I am not. Where are you going?
Get drunker. I need to think.
Well, let's do that again to get some horny answers. So did Hank drive here, park, say wait in the car, and then go lurk?
Nice view, huh? I used to come here a lot before.
Before what?
Hmm?
You said, I used to come here a lot before. Before what?
Before...
Sunday, motherfucker.
Before nothing.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant?
Do all androids ask so many personal questions, or is it just you?
Why are you so determined to kill yourself?
Some things I just can't forget. Whatever I do, they're always there, eating away at me. I don't have the guts to pull the trigger, so I kill myself a little every day. That's probably difficult for you to understand, huh, Connor? Nothing very rational about it.
We're not making any progress on this investigation. The Deviants have nothing in common. They're all different models, produced at different times, in different places.
Well, there must be some link.
Could be a hardware problem. Maybe a defective biocomponent?
Well, I don't know much about biocomponents, but I'll bet that's not the fucking reason.
You seem preoccupied, Lieutenant. Is it something to do with what happened back at the Eden Club?
Those two girls. They just wanted to be together. They really seemed... in love.
You seem troubled, Lieutenant. I didn't think machines could have such an effect on you.
What about you, Connor? You look human. You sound human. But what are you really?
You know exactly what I am. In any case, I don't see how that's relevant to the investigation.
You could have shot those two girls, but you didn't. Why didn't you shoot Connor? Some scruple suddenly enter into your program?
No. I just decided not to shoot. That's all.
I could kill you. You would just come back as if nothing happened. But are you afraid to die, Connor?
Why would I be afraid?
What'll happen if I pull this trigger? Hmm? Nothing? Oblivion? Android heaven?
Where does all your anger come from, Lieutenant? Some unresolved trauma in your past?
You think you're so fucking smart. Always one step ahead, huh? Tell me this, smartass. How do I know you're not a deviant?
I self-test regularly. I know what I am and what I am not. Where are you going?
Get drunker. I need to think.
I failed to get the horny answers again. At least I did it on my first run. Should I keep doing that one, or should I do another one? God, I'm in deep. I'm in hell. We're all in hell. I'm fucked. All right, different answers this time.
Nice view, huh? I used to come here a lot before.
You should stop drinking, Lieutenant. It could have serious consequences for your health.
That's the idea.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant?
Do all androids ask so many personal questions, or is it just you?
Why are you so determined to kill yourself?
Some things I just can't forget. Whatever I do, they're always there, eating away at me. I don't have the guts to pull the trigger, so I kill myself a little every day. That's probably difficult for you to understand, huh, Connor? Nothing very rational about it.
We're not making any progress on this investigation. The Deviants have nothing in common. They're all different models, produced at different times, in different places.
Well, there must be some link.
We know the Deviants experienced an emotional shock, a violent trauma, or a sense of injustice.
Those girls at the Eden Club sure had a reason to feel a sense of injustice.
You seem preoccupied, Lieutenant. Is it something to do with what happened back at the Eden Club?
Those two girls, they just wanted to be together. They really seemed in love.
They didn't want anything. They're deviants. End of story.
What about you, Connor? You look human. You sound human. But what are you really?
I'm a machine, designed to accomplish a task. I know why I exist and who designed me. I have a reason to live. I guess that's the difference between us, Lieutenant.
Damn.
You could have shot those two girls, but you didn't. Why didn't you shoot, Connor? Some scruple suddenly enter into your program?
I would have shot them if I could. Why would I let them escape?
You and you would just come back as if nothing happened. But are you afraid to die, Connor?
I would certainly find it regrettable to be interrupted before I can finish this investigation.
What'll happen if I pull this trigger? Nothing? Oblivion? Android heaven?
You know you're not going to shoot me, Lieutenant. You're just trying to provoke a reaction. I'm afraid I'm going to have to disappoint you.
You think you're so fucking smart. Always one step ahead, huh? Tell me this, smartass. How do I know you're not a deviant?
I self-test regularly. I know what I am and what I am not. Where are you going?
To get drunker.
That was horny.
I need to think.
One more time.
Nice view, huh? I used to come here a lot before.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant?
Do all androids ask so many personal questions, or is it just you?
I saw a photo of a child on your kitchen table. It was your son, right?
Yeah. His name was Cole.
You should stop drinking, Lieutenant. It could have serious consequences for your health.
That's the idea.
We're not making any progress on this investigation. The deviants have nothing in common. They're all different models, produced at different times, in different places.
Well, there must be some link.
It could be a software problem that only occurs under certain conditions.
Well, that's just a fancy way of saying you have no fucking idea.
You seem preoccupied, Lieutenant. Is it something to do with what happened back at the Eden Club?
Those two girls. They just wanted to be together. They really seemed in love.
Nothing in their program allows them to love or desire anything. They're machines.
What about you, Connor? You look human, you sound human, but what are you really?
I'm whatever you want me to be, Lieutenant.
There it is.
Your partner? Your buddy to drink with? Or just a machine, designed to accomplish a task?
You could have shot those two girls, but you didn't. Why didn't you shoot, Connor? Some scruple suddenly enter into your program?
No. I just decided not to shoot. That's all.
I could kill you, and you would just come back as if nothing happened. But are you afraid to die, Connor?
Why would I be afraid?
What'll happen if I pull this trigger? Nothing? Oblivion? Android heaven?
Nothing. There would be nothing. Where are you going?
Get drunker. I need to think.
Yay!
Starting to piss me off with that coin, Connor.
Sorry, Lieutenant.
79th floor.
Hi, Hank.
Shit, what's going on here? There was a party and nobody told me about it?
Yeah, it's all over the news, so everybody's butting their nose in. Even the FBI wants a piece of the action.
Ah, Christ, now we got the feds on our back. I knew this was gonna be a shitty day. So what do we got?
Four androids. They knew the building, and they were very well organized. I'm still trying to figure out how they got this far without being noticed.
Did you check the roof?
Not yet. There's so much to look at.
We have to make sure we check it out.
They attacked two guards in the hallway. They probably thought the androids were coming to do maintenance. They got taken down before they could react. Station employee. Shot through the back as he was trying to get away. One bullet straight through the heart from 50 feet. Now that's the kind of shooting only an android could do.
How many people were working here?
Just two employees and three androids. The deviants took the humans hostage and broadcast their message live. Then made their getaway from the roof.
Roof?
Yeah, they jumped to parachutes. We're still trying to figure out where they landed, but the weather's not helping. If you want to take a look at the video broadcast by the deviants, it's on that screen over there. Oh, Lieutenant, this is Special Agent Perkins from the FBI. Lieutenant Anderson is in charge of investigating for Detroit Police.
What's that?
My name is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife.
Androids investigating androids, huh? You sure you want an android hanging around? After everything that happened? Whatever. The FBI would take over the investigation, you'd soon be off the case. Well,
pleasure meeting you. Have a nice day.
And you watch your step. Don't fuck up my crime scene.
What a fucking prick.
I'll be nearby. If you need anything, just ask.
All right, well, let's have a look around. Let me know if you find anything.
Okay, Lieutenant.
Just gonna follow Hank around for a while, see if he plays with the coin.
We ask that you recognize our dignity, our hopes, and our rights. Together, we can live in peace and build a better future for humans and androids. This message is the hope of a future. You gave us life, and now the time has come for you to give us freedom.
Think that's RA9?
Deviants say RA9 will set them free. This android seems to have that objective.
Where's the third one? Come on. There we go.
You see something?
I identified its model and serial number.
Anything else I should know?
No. Nothing. Didn't break in?
No, no signs of forced entry.
There are cameras in the hallway. The staff would have seen what was happening. Why did they let him in?
Maybe they didn't check the cameras.
We stored the station androids in the kitchen. There's no evidence that they were involved, but we didn't know what else to do with them.
What is your function?
I am a broadcast operator.
State your model.
Model GB300. Serial number 336-445-581.
Have you been in contact with any other androids recently?
Only station androids in the normal course of my function.
Run a diagnostic.
All systems fully operational.
Has anybody accessed your memory recently?
Not to my knowledge.
Were you present when the deviants broke in?
I do not remember.
One of you saw the attack on the surveillance cameras and said nothing. Which means there's a deviant in this room. And I'm going to find out which it is. Why should you all be destroyed if only one is deviant? Turn yourself in, or two innocent androids will be shut down because of you. You're going to be switched off. We're going to search your memory and tear you apart piece by piece for analysis. You're going to be destroyed. Do you hear me? Destroyed!
Thank you.
If you give yourself up, maybe I can convince the humans not to destroy you.
Nice shot, Connor.
I wanted it alive.
You saved human lives. You saved my life.
Hank, you're in love. Ugh, I don't want to do Kamsky again. I've had enough of that guy. Thank you. This better not make me play Kara and Marcus parts. I just want the good parts. Detroit Become Human, good parts version.
Step back, Connor! And I'll spare him!
Sorry, Connor. This bastard's your spitting image.
No!
The bus terminal. We've arrived, Alice. We made it. On. We're stuck here now. What are we going to do? I think Oliver likes you. Is she yours? Yes. She's adorable.
That's it. Got the sandwiches. I called your mom. Let's get going before we miss our bus. You got the tickets, right?
Yes, honey, in my bag.
Great. Let's go then. I don't believe it.
I don't know what happened.
You can't have lost them. Did you have a good look in your bag?
They were in my backpack. The envelope must have fallen.
Fuck. Excuse me, you didn't happen to see a blue envelope somewhere, did you? It has our bus tickets in it, and... Oh, never mind.
No. Sorry.
What are we gonna do? We can't stay here. We have to find a safe place for Oliver.
I'm so sorry, honey. I don't know what happened. They were right here in my bag.
Security check. Got your tickets?
Yes, here they are.
Okay, go ahead.
Because of us. We had to make a choice, Alice. was them or us.
They're fine. Emma? Hello, Emma. Things I do to get to sexy Connor on Connor action. Fuck me.
We've got to finish the barricade. Come on, help me. Hey, help me!
Is trying to eat my headphone cord.
Right, that should do it.
We all know that's not going to stop them. Just hope it buys us some time.
I know it was not an easy decision to make, but I'm sure we're doing the right thing.
All right, let's get through this as fast as possible.
Are you all right?
They shot into the crowd. Many of us were killed. It could have been me. Scared. I don't want to shut down.
They're slaughtering our people in those camps. We can't just leave them and forget everything we are, everything we believe in.
Maybe we should have never asked for freedom. None of this would have happened if we'd stayed silent.
Stop there. What are we going to do if they attack?
Resist. That's the only thing we can do.
Do you think Connor has any chance of making it?
We can only count on ourselves now.
Marcus, we found what you asked for.
There's some journalists over there. We have to make sure they know what's going on.
Yeah, pretty much anybody but, Marcus North.
Many of our people have fallen. The humans have no pity for those who are different.
Yeah.
This won't hold him for long, but I guess it's better than nothing.
They're getting into position.
If they attack, no one will survive.
There's no other way out. They are going to kill us. The only hope we have left is that we don't die for nothing.
You're the hope of our people. I trust you. We all trust you. No matter what happens now, we're making history. Marcus! Marcus, come look!
Marcus? I've come to talk to you, Marcus. Come on. You have my word. We won't try anything.
Don't go. It's a trap. They want to get you out in the open. Don't go, Marcus.
I just want to talk.
I have nothing else to say. Free our people, then we'll talk.
I came here to negotiate. Isn't that what you want?
I gave you my answer.
Want to play it like that? Okay.
Please finish this. Let me get back to Connor.
The humans are about to launch an attack. And we will show them. And we are not afraid. If we must die today, then we will die free.
Here we go.
Your friend's life is in your hands. Now it's time to decide what matters most. Him or the revolution?
Don't listen to him. Everything this fucker says is a lie.
That human means nothing to me. You can kill him if you want. I don't care. I have access to your memory. I know you've developed some kind of attachment to him.
Mm-hmm.
Are you really ready to let him die after all you've been through? Are you really going to turn your back on who you've become? If I surrender, how do I know you won't kill him? I'll only do what is strictly necessary to accomplish my mission. It's up to you whether or not that includes killing this human. Enough talk! It's time to decide who you really are. Are you going to save your partner's life? Or are you going to sacrifice him? All right. You win. Hank, I don't know how I would have managed without you. Get rid of him. We have no time to lose. It's me, Hank. I'm the real Connor.
One of you is my partner.
The other is a sack of shit. Question is, who's who?
What are you doing, Hank? I'm the real Connor. Give me the gun and I'll
take
care of
it. Don't move!
Why don't you ask us something? Something only the real Connor would know.
Where did we first meet?
Jimmy's bar. I checked four other bars before I found you. We went to the scene of a homicide. The victim's name was Carlos Ortiz.
He uploaded my memory.
What's my dog's name?
Sumo. His name is Sumo. I knew that too.
My son, what's his name?
Cole. His name was Cole. And he just turned 6 at the time of the accident. It wasn't your fault, Lieutenant. A truck skidded on a sheet of ice and your car rolled over. Cole needed emergency surgery, but no human was available to do it. So an android had to take care of him. Cole didn't make it. That's why you hate androids. You think one of us is responsible for your son's death.
Cole died because a human surgeon was too high on red ice to operate. He was the one that took my son from me. Him in this world where the only way people can find comfort is with a fistful of powder. Every time you died and came back, I thought about Cole. How much I wanted to bring him back. I'd have given anything to hold him again. But humans don't come back.
I knew about your son, too. I would have said exactly the same thing. Don't listen to him, Hank. I'm the one who...
Yeah, I've learned a lot since I met you, Connor. Maybe there's something to this. Maybe you really are alive. Maybe you'll be the ones to make the world a better place. Go ahead, do what you gotta do.
Up.
Wake up, 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 wake up.
All right, that's enough. All right, I think that is enough content for now. Maybe I'll do this more Connor content, all of it, do every option. All right, I love you all. Bye-bye.